Just as for the male reproductive system, for the female reproductive system, we'll go over the anatomy as well as the organ functions, and then we'll talk about the physiology of the female system. We will start with the external anatomy of the female reproductive system. For the external anatomy, also known as the vulva, we will talk about the mons pubis, the labia majora, the labia minora, and the clitoris. And to put this in perspective, this is the front of a female, and this is the rear. So we can see the two buttocks here. The mons pubis, also known as the mons veneris, is the fatty tissue that covers the front of the pubic bone. And it is there to protect and cushion the internal reproductive organs that are located right inside that fatty tissue. This is also where hair will grow during puberty, so that pubic hair will occur in that area. The labia or labium majora are the heavy folds of skin that surround the opening of the vagina, and their purpose is to protect that vaginal opening. The labia minora are the two smaller folds of skin that are located within the labia majora, so they're inside those thicker folds of skin and surround the opening of the vagina. They have the same function as the labia majora. They protect that vaginal opening, so that vaginal opening has essentially two folds of skin that protect it. The clitoris is a highly sensitive skin structure that's located above the opening of the urethra. It has a rich supply of blood vessels and nerve endings located in it, making it highly sensitive. This is why many females get a lot of pleasure from this organ during sexual activity. Moving on to the internal female reproductive anatomy, we can see the side view and a front view of the internal organs. The first part of the female reproductive organs that we will start with are the ovaries, which are located right there or right here in that side view. The ovaries are the female sex gland that store ova or eggs. It also produces the female sex hormones, estrogen, and progesterone. Ova do mature in the ovaries until they are released. The fallopian tubes are about 4 inches long and connect the ovary to the uterus. So typically there are two of them, although a female can live with just one fallopian tube or none at all. There are cilia located inside the fallopian tubes, just like the vas deferens, that wave and help move an ovum or egg through the tube. This is also where fertilization will occur. So when an egg or a sperm fertilizes an egg, it's going to occur in the upper two-thirds of the fallopian tube. The fallopian tubes don't actually directly connect to the ovaries. Instead, they have these finger-like projections on the end of them called fimbriae, spelled F-R-I-M-B-R-A-E. So these act like a broom and sweep the egg into the fallopian tube. So once it's released, those fimbriae kind of grab it and sweep it into the fallopian tube to pass through the rest of the female system. From the fallopian tubes, an egg will pass into the uterus. And the uterus is this hollow organ that has thick muscular walls that nourish and protects a fertilized ovum or egg until birth. So if a fertilized egg attaches itself into the walls of the uterus, that uterus will protect and nourish that growing fetus, and it will expand as that fetus develops. It also contracts during childbirth to help deliver a baby, and is lined with this tissue called the endometrium. The endometrium is that bloody tissue that is expelled during menstruation or a female's period. Just like for the male reproductive system, the urinary bladder is not part of the female system. It is that sac that holds urine that's produced by the kidneys, and is in that area, so that's why I mention it again, but it is not part of the reproductive system. Different from the male reproductive system, the urethra is not part of the female reproductive system. It is just a passageway for urine to exit the body. The cervix is the opening at the lower end of the uterus. It will dilate during childbirth to allow that baby to pass through, and it connects the uterus to the vagina. It is also a common site for cancer in females. Lastly, the vagina is the muscular tube that leads from the cervix to the outside of the body. It is the female organ for sexual intercourse and has also been known as the birth canal, although that's not the scientific name for it. It is a passageway for both a baby to pass through during childbirth as well as menstrual flow during a female's period or menstruation. Now that we've talked about all of the reproductive organs for the female reproductive system, let's talk about its main player, the egg or ovum. The ovum is the female reproductive cell and carries the genetic information. This is similar to that of sperm in the male reproductive system. The biggest difference between the two is that while males can reproduce sperm every single day, females are born with all of the eggs that they will have in their entire lifetime. That's typically between 200,000 and 400,000 immature ova, and they're located in the ovaries. Here's the kicker though. Only about 375 of those will actually mature and be released. The ova begin to develop during puberty, each one being enclosed in what's called a follicle. The follicle is essentially a hard outer shell that protects and matures that ovum. When an egg matures to its full maturation level, it's released from the follicle during ovulation. So it bursts from that follicular shell and is swept up by the fimbriae into the fallopian tubes. That follicle remains in the ovaries and turns into something else called the corpus luteum. This is a temporary yellow-bodied gland that secretes progesterone, which is that other hormone besides estrogen that is a main player in the female reproductive system. And we'll talk more about what progesterone does and what role it plays when we talk about menstruation and the menstrual cycle. So to recap, that ovum starts in the ovary, it matures until it gets to that full maturation level inside its follicle. When it's fully matured, it'll burst from the follicle, be swept up by those finger-like projections on the end of the fallopian tubes into the fallopian tube where it will travel to the uterus. If it's fertilized, it'll happen in the upper two-thirds of the fallopian tube and attach itself into the uterine wall. If not, it will either disintegrate in the uterus or be shed with the uterine lining called the endometrium during menstruation. That will exit through the cervix and the vagina.